Charles Dietrichson held all the cards, but he couldn't hold on to his wife. If he'd never come to see me that day, maybe he'd still be alive.
Thank you.
Your thoughts straight. One of the facts was a name. Ellis. The guy in the photo. But what was so frightening about this guy? Dietrichson wasn't waiting around to say. Anyhow, two things were certain. My client was scared. And someone wasn't getting gold stars for trust.
Thank you.
I was working on a case. It just seemed like this case was working on me. I couldn't sleep. Who was the girl? I wasn't looking at anything in particular, but the facts kept going over in my mind. The suspect, the client. What was the story? I don't know. People expect a private operator to know all the right moves. They see in all the right movies. The movies are simple. Good guys. Bad guys. Reality has a different angle. There's good money and bad money. The trust commodities sign kept on flashing outside. Dietrichson's company. Reminded me who made the rules. Start with the girl. There was something familiar about her face. She had class, and that was something I didn't know about. She was all I had to go on, her and a press clipping. My client's firm wasn't all Hail Marys and charity donations. Paper told me that much. But Dietrichson was a big wheel. He made money. So why did she leave him? I've been drinking hard all night. Didn't help me think none, but it kept me awake. Anyhow, I had to meet with Dietrichson. All I had to show him was a photo of a goddamn tombstone. As it was, he had to take time off the country club to fit me in. Dietrichson was gonna be sore. Thank you. was right about one thing, though. Dietrichson didn't like it. One bit. He told me to lay off the lead I was working on. But it was the only one I had. One of the first rules is never do what you're told. The second is make a little money. Who says it's easy being a private detective? Anyhow, I figured Dietrichson has commissioned a few tombstones in his time.